Okay, now it's my countdown to 3 o'clock. 30 seconds to go. Trying to do this on the meter.
Hey, well, hello everybody. I'm Gary Lucas, and I'm live streaming from the beautiful West Village of Manhattan on this lovely afternoon. So lovely. What am I doing inside playing? No. Well, I'm having fun. I hope you will too. And I'll tell you more about it. Okay, just gonna play.
Thank you.
I think this is almost the 300th live stream since lockdown. Gotta check that with Webmaster Tom, who archives everything. But in any case, tomorrow on WKCR-FM, which is Columbia University's radio station, I am the guest of my old friend Mitch Goldman on his Deep Focus broadcast, which is then a podcast, I think a week later, and archived. And we're doing a deep focus on Abdullah Ibrahim. And I don't want to give away the show too much, other than I'm there to wax enthusiastic about this, to me, one of the greatest living jazz musicians left. No, there's new ones cropping up all the time. It's a living tradition. But certainly just about my favorite. And I was touched very deeply the first time I heard a record of his on ECM Records called African Piano under the name Dollar Grand, which was his original moniker, apparently named after the dollar brand of cigar that he liked to smoke in his native South Africa. But he converted to Islam and became Abdullah Ibrahim somewhere along the way on a recording career that must encompass, oh, at least 100 different albums. And they're all fascinating to me. I don't have all of them. I have a bunch, and I like so many of them. But if you get a chance, catch him. He was in New York recently, and I failed to see him this time around. But I have seen him live, and he's always terrific. So anyway, tune into that on WKCR. I think the link is on the timeline. I posted about it, Mitch posted about it, because it should be a good show. And he unearthed all sorts of rarities from various appearances in the New York area. Actually, Ibrahim was living in New York City for a while. He's quite a global musician. And anyway, I urge you to check out his music. It's really great. One of the best, what can I say? It touches me really deeply as a keyboard player. And he's certainly, I don't know, he hits all the right notes. They rub me the right way. So anyway, just wanted to say it was really enjoyable to play out in New Jersey yesterday in the early evening for the Rocktoberfest. It's only September, but already they have this annual music festival. There must have been, I don't know, 30, 40 different aggregations there. We were considered, I guess, one of the headliners, thanks a lot. And it was myself, Fei-Fei Young, and Fred Liu. Unfortunately, Jason Candler, my old buddy in this ensemble, can't be in it currently, but we're hoping he makes a full recovery. But Fred more than compensated for the lack of a third voice on keyboards. And Fei-Fei was the usual brilliant self. And a lot of fun was had by all, though we didn't get to play our full set, unfortunately. There's like, you know, somebody honking the horn very obnoxiously out in the street. It's like almost something I could make into music. I don't know if you're picking it up. Yeah, you probably are. Great. Annoying. Well, it's, oh, let me stop. It's fun to play here in the West Village. Usually a quiet situation, but sometimes on the weekend, a lot of activity. And such a beautiful day. So anyway, what else? Oh, I had a great gig with Peter Stanfill also. They just reissued our album, No Knowledge of Music Required, on the Don Giovanni label. Check it out. It has five or six extra tracks. We recorded down in New Orleans where we did the bulk of the album at the turn of the century, doesn't it sound quite? I think it was about, the album came out in 2000. It was actually recorded around 96 or so. And then we went back down there in 2008. So it's out. It was fun to play with Peter as always. And I'll close with some Chinese pop music. Stuff that I just wanted to repeat because I love playing it and I think you'll enjoy it. Thank you.
Yeah, okay, well, that was the mad world.
Isn't it the truth? The mad world, a song by Zhou Xuan, otherwise known as the Golden Voice of China, from the fantastic golden age of Shanghai pop. I love doing this project with Feifei and Fred because it's, you know, I often felt on a mission trying to spread the word about music that I get excited about that I think other people would like if they were exposed to it. And this is particularly a genre that's kind of occluded to most Westerners that just don't know about it. It's rarely played. Certainly not on the radio. Although, Frankie Lane, who had a hit with Rawhide Theme, all the oldsters out there can recall that, had a hit with a Chinese pop song. I think it was Rose, Rose, I Love You. I'll have to play that another time. But he changed the lyrics to make a completely different song from the original song from the late 40s. But it caught on, and it might have gone to number one. Anyway, it was a hit. Who would have thunk it? So I wouldn't necessarily write off the genre for it. And that's what I wanted to hold up a couple of albums here, recent albums. Okay. Double Dare with my friend, the extremely talented young Dutch acoustic bassist, singer Peter Willems, and this is out on the Zenez label. I'm coming over for a gig at a great jazz club in Holland early next month at the Paradox in Tilburg, and Peter and I will be playing. We're working on some new music currently for another release, and then this has just come out. Okay, on the Mighty Quinn label, the Great Lost Gods and Monsters live album, which is my longtime band at a peak form with the lineup that definitely featured Downtown Luminaries, Jerry Harrison from Talking Heads on keyboards, Ernie Brooks on bass, Jason Candler from the Hungry March Band, and Earth People on alto sax, and Billy Ficca from Television and Drums and myself. And this caught us at a great moment on a night, I think it was at the Bowery Poetry Club during the CMJ. And anyway, tomorrow on Mitch's show, I'm going to play a track because we did a really smoking version of Abdul Ibrahim, Dollar Brand, Bracho from Kilimanjaro. So that, okay, ties a nice ribbon around the show. Thank you for tuning in. And now it's time for me to turn it. No, I have Julia Crowe coming by in a little while. He's a great guitar player and wrote a book called My First Guitar. I'm one of the guitarists interviewed in that book, along with Jimmy Page and some other greats, talking about our first guitar experiences and how we got into it. Anyway, I'll see you next Sunday, same time, 3 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in.
And love you guys. Take care.